and she believes that she talks to the Virgin Mary. Take your bag off and slide it across to me. What? The bag, said Nightingale, nodding at Connolly's backpack. I need to look inside it. Take it off, very slowly. You think I have a gun? Or a knife? Either way, I know that you're lying, and that you came here to do her harm. And then what? You'll shoot me. I'll call the cops. You broke in here as well, remember? Nightingale shook his head. I was invited in by Tracy's uncle. It's his house. He gave me the key. Do you have a key? Oh no, of course not. You smashed a window to get in. Connolly nodded at the shotgun in Nightingale's hands. And you've got a license for that sawn-off shotgun, of course. Mate, I'll whack you over the head with it, hide it, and then call the cops. Oh, and I used to be a cop, so there's a good chance they'll listen to me. He gestured at the backpack with his gun. Take it off. Connolly scowled, but did as he was told. Push it over here, said Nightingale. Not too enthusiastically. I'd hate to pull the trigger accidentally. Connolly pushed the bag across the floor. Nightingale pointed the gun at his face. Now, put your hands behind your neck again. Connolly obeyed the instructions. Now, move your right foot over your left. Connolly did as he was told. Nightingale nodded his approval. In that position, Connolly wouldn't be able to get the jump on him. He kept the shotgun aimed at Connolly's chest with his right hand while he used his left to root around inside of the bag. He pulled out two rolls of duct tape and tossed them onto the kitchen table. Then he took out a small leather wallet with a zip running around the outer edge.